Okay, so as per the syllabus or as per the list of the practicals, we are going to conduct near about 12 practicals of embedded systems. Just like in the previous semester, you were having the subject of MAA, that means practicals which were related to 8051 microcontroller. The similar type of practicals will be available for embedded system also. Because in the theoretical part of embedded system, we also have studied about 8051 microcontroller. So whenever we are dealing with the practicals of different microcontrollers, we have to use a software for that purpose. And for 8051 microcontroller, we already know that we are using a Keil software. Okay, so in this complete syllabus of embedded system practicals, we will be using a Keil software and we will be developing a C programs for interfacing as well as for general applications. Now, as we know, we have studied the Keil practical, Keil software, how to use it, that also we know it. So in the Keil, we are able to design any assembly code or any C code. So in the Keil software, you can either develop a code in assembly language or you can develop a code in C language. In microcontroller, that means in MAA subject, we have developed the code in assembly language, whereas in embedded system, we will be developing a code in C language. Okay, so immediately we will start with the basic practicals of embedded systems. Theoretical part of all the practicals are already covered in unit number 2, correct? Basic C programs we already have seen in theoretical part of chapter 2 or unit 2. We have seen how to form a basic C program, how to give a header file, how to write different kinds of functions, how to declare different variables, how to call a function, how to call a function definition. All this part we already have seen, okay? So in today's session, we will be discussing or a very basic part we will start with, that how to use the Keil software. How to create a separate file in the Keil software, how to make your new project, how to execute that project, how to create the hex file of that project, and all those things. Okay, so today we will just see how to use the software and how to form a basic program. In your first practical, we will be having a title as write a C program to develop arithmetic and logical operations. Like arithmetic operation means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Logical operations means ANDing, ORing, XORing, and so on. So our basic programs will be based on these operations only. Okay, so we will start. So I am doing some screen sharing here. So you can see I have shared a screen. Hope so you are able to see, and hope so that you are able to hear my voice also. Sagyana awaz yeto hai? Yes. Maza awaz sarvana yeto hai ka? एटलीस्ट काही तरी रिप्लाय द्या म्हणजे मला पुढचं स्टार्ट करता येईल. आवाज येतोय माझा?
हो मॅम, आवाज येतोय.
ओके, ठीक आहे. आता एक स्क्रीन तुमच्या समोर आहे. दिस इज अ स्क्रीन ऑफ Keil सॉफ्टवेअर. आय एम युझिंग Keil मायक्रो विजन 2 फॉर परफॉर्मिंग द प्रॅक्टिकल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी दॅट हाऊ टू यूज दिस सॉफ्टवेअर अँड हाऊ टू क्रिएट युअर न्यू प्रोजेक्ट. यू ऑलरेडी हॅव स्टडीड दिस पार्ट इन MAA ऑल्सो. Again, we are going to revise this and we will start the practical immediately. Okay, so whenever this kind of screen arrives on the in your laptops or in your PCs, then first of all we have to go in this project, then we have to select this close project. Now in this close project is disabled here, so need not to worry. But if it is enabled here, then you have to first close project. After that, again, you go in the project, say new project. Now this file will appear here. In this, you have to create your new project. So for that, you first of all select your basic drive. For example, I will select, suppose F drive I have selected, and this F drive I am writing, or I will create one new folder first of all. In this, I will create one new folder. I will give the name for the folder. For example, ESY practicals. This is the name of a folder. And in this folder, if you open, you have to give the file name. For example, I will give exp1 and say save. After that, this window will appear. This window is used for selecting your device on which you are going to do the program. So we are basically using microcontroller 8051, and we are having different kinds of manufacturers, out of which we have to select Atmel. And in this Atmel, you have to select our device, that is 8089C51RD2. When I click on this device, to the right hand side, I can see there are features of that device. Okay, say okay. There will be one message displayed here. You say yes. Okay. Now your device is selected. Now for that device, you have to write a code. So for that, you will go here in file, say new. So a text window will appear here. In this text window, you have to type a code. Now I want to type our code in C language now. I'm not using assembly, but I want to type the code in C language. So first of all, we'll give one header file. Say for example, sorry, not in caps. This is a case sensitive language. So all the things should be in small letters wherever they are required. Hash include reg51.h. This is your header file used for 8051 microcontroller. Then you write, for example, void main, void, then curly bracket opening. Suppose I will just write our basic program to perform, for example, addition of two numbers. So I have to take some variables. For that, I have to declare the variables. For example, unsigned character, say A, B, C. Okay. Then we have to take which values or hexadecimal numbers we will consider. For example, say A variable is holding the value as 0x, any value you can consider. This is 0x34, means it is a hexadecimal value which we have defined, or which we have said that it is declared in the variable A. Similarly, for example, B equal to take another value, for example 0x0 or A9, any value you can consider. Okay, this is also a hexadecimal value. And for example, next say C equal to A plus B. This program we already have studied in the theoretical part. C equal to A plus B. This equal to sign indicate that the right-hand side value will be copied to the left-hand side. To the right-hand side, which operation we are performing? We are performing A plus B. This plus sign is a operator used for addition, correct? So right-hand side operation, that means A plus B, addition will be done of A and B variables. Values which are stored in A and B, those values will be added and the result will be copied in C variable. Okay, so if you want this result to be stored in some other port or some other variable, in that also you can mention. For example, any port we will consider, say suppose port 1. Remember that for name of the ports, I am using capital P. Okay, because if I use small p, then it will not be identified as a port. So the port names are always given in capital P. Suppose it is port 1, then I will write P1, capital P1. If it is port 0, then I will write capital P0, likewise. Okay, say equal to C. Okay, so in C variable, we are having our result, addition result. So that result you can copy to some other port. For example, it is P1. Okay. So here I can add my code. Okay. Now I have typed my code here. If you want, you can have your while one loop also. If you want, then it is optional. व्हाइल वन लूप तुम्ही ऍड करू शकता. व्हाइल वन म्हणजे कंटिन्युअस ऑपरेशन साठी आहे. सो दिस इज नॉट कंपल्सरी, बट यू कॅन यूज इफ यू वॉन्ट इट. सो दिस इज अवर सिंपल प्रोग्राम टू परफॉर्म ऍडिशन. नाउ वन्स यू टाइप युअर कोड, यू हॅव टू सेव्ह दिस कोड. सो अगेन वी विल गो इन फाईल, आय विल से सेव्ह ॲज. Then you have to check that wherever this file is going to be saved. You are having our folder name as ESY practicals. Then we are having the file name as experiment 1 or exp1. And here you have to write dot C. Why C? Because our program is in a C language. If the program is written in assembly language, then we are writing dot ASM. Correct? So now here we will write it as dot C, remember, and then we will say save. Okay, now our file is saved. After that, what we do, we are adding our file here. Go in target one. This file is not required, so I will just remove it. I'll go here, right click, add files. And which file is ours? See, our folder is here. Our file is exp1.c. This file you have to select. Say add and say close. Now our file has been added here. After this, just a minute. Okay, so after this, we will check the errors if there are present in this file or in this program. So for error checking, we are having this option, that is translate current file. Click on it. Okay, so here I got zero error, zero warnings. That means my program is exactly correct. There is no any error here. Once you get zero error, zero warnings, then you click on the second option, that is build a target. Again, zero error, zero warnings. And again, rebuild all target files, click on it. Again, zero error, zero warnings, correct? Now, after this, your program is correct now, you have to run this code. For that, we are going in debug and say start debug. Okay. Now your code will be run in this way. If you want to see where our results are getting stored, then you can see in this AB variables and C variable. But our final result is being copied in port 1. So you can select our port 1 from your peripherals. So here we are not able to see the peripheral option. Okay, so here we are having one option called as a peripherals. And from that peripherals, you can select port 1 and then you can check the result. So for debug, what we do, F10 key we are pressing. Okay, so our result is A plus B. Okay. So our result of A plus B will be stored in C variable. Again, if you do F10, the C variable value will be copied in port 1. Okay. So in port 1, if you want to see, I'm not able to show you now here, but in your software, whenever you install in your laptops, there you can go in this peripheral. Here you can see P option is there. Here peripheral, yes. Peripherals, go in this input output ports and from here you can select port 1. See now, what data you can see in the port 1, here it is 0xDD. DD means it is again a hexadecimal number. In binary it is 11011101. So it is DDH. So our first value is 34H, second value is A9H. When you add these two numbers in hexadecimal, you will get the result as DDH. Again, it is a hexadecimal number. So in port 1, you have that result. Okay. So according to our code, this answer is correct. If you want, you can check on the calculators also. You can cross verify your results likewise. Okay, this is how you can execute a simple program in the Keel software. Understood now? Yes. This is how we can perform any practical in this Keel software. This was just a basic practical of addition. Likewise, you can perform any basic practical based on any arithmetic and logical operations. Okay, so now any doubt regarding this? Kunala kai questions ahe ka?